Hi guys, Ty Lord here with the DVD collection video. I'm gonna be sharing my martial art movie collection. I have quite a few of them. These are not your typical martial art movies for the most part. I have a strange taste in them. I really like the 90s straight to video variety of martial arts movie. Those were big when I was a kid. Most of these never made it to the show. I don't have a lot of the older Chinese or Hong Kong movies. Most of these are 90s martial art movies. Some of them are big ones, like some Van Damme ones. I'm gonna use the Van Dammes as sort of a base to get through all these, and Bruce Lee and Van Damme movies sort of as a base or the foundation to how I have these organized, how I have these categorized. I'm gonna go through my martial art movie DVD collection, some Blu-rays and laser discs in here too. So I'll start off with just some random ones I have here. I couldn't quite figure out how to categorize them. Here's the a little ninja collection here. Rage of Honor with Shokusugi, American Ninja with Michael Dudikoff, and Revenge of the Ninja with Shokusugi. I think this American Ninja, the first one, is the only one I've ever seen, and it's quite enjoyable. Anyway, Jackie Chan's First Strike, have that one. This is one of the only Jackie Chan movies I have. I'm a fan of his, but this is the only one I have, and I don't even think I've seen this, or it's been a long time, so I don't remember. My favorite Jackie Chan movie, though, is Meals on Wheels, or Wheels on Meals. Here is Raiders of the Sun with Richard Norton. It's more of an action, post-apocalyptic movie, but Richard Norton's in there doing karate moves. This is directed by Sergio H. Santiago, one of my favorite post-apocalyptic movie directors. Movie from the Philippines here. A lot of good ones, as far as I'm concerned. Some Chuck Norris movies. I got this little action pack with Delta Force, Delta Force 2, and Code of Silence. These are average to above average action movies, from what I remember. It's been a while since I've seen them. Here are my two favorite Chuck Norris movies. One is Firewalker with one of my favorite actors, Lou Gossett Jr. And this is sort of an adventure movie. It's sort of like in the same vein of Indiana Jones. And these guys are buddies, Chuck Norris and Lou Gossett Jr. It's sort of a comedy too. This is probably my favorite Chuck Norris performance because he's more of a funny goofball. Usually he plays it straight, serious. He's more of a Jackie Chan type character in this. Like, he's kind of a goofball and he kind of is a troublemaker, and he gets Lou Gossett Jr. into all kinds of problems. But he can back it up with all of his karate kicks. So this is a fun adventure action movie. Kind of a buddy movie. The pretty girl in here is the girl from Flash Gordon. What's her name? Melody Anderson. And here's my other favorite Chuck Norris movie, Silent Rage. Great action movie, great horror movie. With Chuck Norris here. Here's a really, really low budget one. This was probably from the dollar store. I like this movie though. A Warrior of Justice. I don't recognize this main guy. His name's Yorgo Oganovsky. He's like a karate guy, really built karate guy. Has an accent, like Eastern European. I can't tell what he is, but he's the main protagonist of this. His master is Richard Lynch. You probably have seen him in a lot of straight to DVD, straight to VHS, B movies. He always brings his A game to all of these crappy movies. He always reminded me of Ric Flair, this guy. He always would play the bad guy. In this one, he's the sensei of this guy, who was a sensei himself, this movie. I kind of want to highlight this one because not many people know about it. It's a goofy movie. This guy's one of his students goes into these underground illegal fight matches put on by rich people, and he goes missing. So he's kind of looking for his student. He assumes he's dead, or he's in some kind of trouble, and he's off looking for him. And then this fighting tournament's put on by these rich people that it's fights to the death, so they kill the losers and then they harvest their organs and sell them on the black market. It's a hilarious movie. It's typical 90s straight-to-video cheese. I love this one. I don't know if this is 90s or 2000s right here with Boss Rutten. Probably, I don't know if this is the only movie he ever starred in, but it's a cool movie. It's sort of one of those Manhunt movies, sort of like Surviving the Game with Ice-T or Hard Target with Van Damme. Kind of like based on that old, the most Dangerous Game short story. But this is a kind of cool martial arts movie. Boss Rutten fights Marco Huas in here, another UFC fighter. Michael Rooker is in here from Cliffhanger. I haven't seen it in a while, but I remember I liked this movie. I've had it for a while. Here's one I got at the dollar store, Blu-ray, Android Cop. I just got that because it had Michael Jai White in there. He's been in some cool movies. I haven't seen this yet. I'm assuming this is one of these terrible made-for-sci-fi movies. So I have to get out of watch. Here's Kung Pao, Enter the Fist. I don't know if I should have categorized that with my martial arts movie. It's a martial arts comedy. Kung Pao, Enter the Fist, funny movie. Blind Fury with Rutger Hauer. This is a really cool 80s martial art action movie, sort of in the same vein as like a Seagal movie. It really feels like an older Seagal movie. Rutger Hauer's like a war veteran that's been blinded. And he's a master samurai, or he was trained by a master samurai, and now he's lost his sense of seeing, but all of his other senses are heightened, and he's a master samurai. It's an action movie. There are a lot of cool thugs in this one he fights. I think Randall Tex Cobb and a few other goons in here he fights. They're pretty cool. Some Wesley Snipes. I don't know if these are considered martial art movies. Because Wesley Snipes does a lot of karate. Art of War. This is a good one. I saw this at the show with my buddy when I was young. Rising Sun. Again, I don't know if that's considered martial arts, but a cool movie with Sean Connery and Wesley Snipes. And then Demolition Man with Rocky, Sylvester Stallone. Wesley Snipes does a little bit of Kung Fu in here, so I just put it in the pile. This is a cool sci-fi action movie, thriller. Everyone knows about that. Romeo Must Die, I picked up with Jet Li. I don't have too many Jet Li movies. This is one of the ones I have. I think this is around 2000s or late 90s, have that one. Here's another one with DMX, Exit Wounds, Seagal's in there. This is one of the few Seagal movies I have. This was a cool one. I think Michael Jai White was the bad guy in this one. I want to get Cradle to the Grave too. That one, I think Mark Dacascos is the main villain. And here's a movie with Mark Dacascos that I haven't watched yet, The Base. I think I got that for a buck. I like Mark Dacascos. Only the Strong is cool, and I even like Kickboxer 5. Double Dragon's even a guilty pleasure for me, but Mark Dacascos is always good with all of his karate moves or taekwondo, whatever he is. Awesome movie. Really great 80s. Martial arts comedy musical, The Last Dragon. This guy Tai Mok, I never really see him in anything else since then, but he's a really cool character, kind of a humble, down to earth guy. He's like the disciple of Bruce Lee, or follows the teachings of Bruce Lee. Really kooky 80s movie. This doesn't get any more 80s than this. A really funny movie. The bad guy in here is the best. Shogun Shonuff. And here's a couple I just picked up because I'm a fan of the actors in here. I haven't watched them yet. Olivier Gruner in TNT. That looks like an action movie. Olivier Gruner always does all kinds of cool martial arts. I don't know if he's German or French or something. He kind of reminds me of Van Damme. And then I've got this little Hollywood DVD pack. I saw there was a couple of Gary Daniels movies in there, City of Fear and Cold Harvest. And I haven't seen either of those Gary Daniels movies yet. I'm a fan of his, a big fan of quite a few of his movies. Okay, onto the good stuff, onto Bruce Lee. Probably my favorite mainstream martial arts movie star, of course, probably everyone's. Him and Van Damme, my favorites, probably. Oh, and Don the Dragon Wilson. he's kind of overlooked as far as the movies go. I like a lot of other ones, like Billy Blanks and Cynthia Rothrock. I'll get to them later, though. Here's the man here, Bruce Lee. Fist of Fury, also known as Chinese Connection. That was the first big movie he was in, martial arts. Cool movie, classic. The Big Boss, also known as Fist of Fury. Another great one. And then The Way of the Dragon, also known as Return of the Dragon. I think it was always supposed to be Way of the Dragon, but it wasn't released till after Enter the Dragon. So, for marketing to push it, like Bruce Lee's back, it was called Return of the Dragon. But this was actually before Enter the Dragon. A really cool movie. This is where he fights Chuck Norris in the Roman Colosseum, set in Rome. A cool movie, kind of a similar plot to his other movies, but they're all great. And then the big one here, my favorite. Not only one of my favorite martial arts movies, but probably within my top five movies of all time. Enter the Dragon, I got that on DVD here. I've had this copy for a long time. A really cool plot. I love the plot to this movie. It reminds me of a James Bond movie combined with a martial arts movie. Bruce Lee brings his best here. This is a big high budget movie. It's got John Saxon in here and a couple other cool martial artists in here, Jim Kelly and Bolo Young, the first time we see him. Bob Wall's in here, who was in a lot of, he was in a few Bruce Lee movies. This is one of my favorite movies of all time. I really think this is the main inspiration for another movie I have right here, Mortal Kombat. When I first played Mortal Kombat, the look of the game and the setting of the game and the characters, a lot of them reminded me of Enter the Dragon. Same idea of going to a tournament on an island, and there's a big baddie that runs the tournament, like Mr. Han in this. Shang Tsung is sort of like the Mr. Han of this. And this movie came out in the 90s. I saw it when I was a kid, and I based on the game, and I love the movie. I think there's a lot of good nods to Enter the Dragon in here. And Johnny Cage sort of reminds me of John Saxon's character in Enter the Dragon, like he's a rich guy going to the island. He has all of his suitcases, wearing all the nice clothes and everything. I really like this one. The Shang Tsung is awesome, and here's that actor's name is Kari Hiroyuki Tagawa or something. I can't pronounce it. I always forget his name, but he always would play a bad guy in these martial art movies. He was in Kickboxer 2, and then also Showdown in Little Tokyo. He was in Rising Sun also. And then Bond girl Talisa Soto's in here looking good as ever. It was cool they worked a Bond girl in here. Always happy to see the Bond girls in movies. Yeah, cool movie. You should have heard what the original cast, who they wanted for the originally to be in the cast. Van Damme as Johnny Cage and Brandon Lee as Liu Kang. These guys were great, but can you imagine that if it would have been Van Damme and Brandon Lee? And then another movie I think really inspired Mortal Kombat is Big Trouble in Little China. I don't really know if you consider that a martial art movie. There is a lot of martial arts in it with Kurt Russell here. David Lopan, or James Hong is in this, and he plays the baddie in here, David Lopan, the evil wizard. Reminds me a lot of Shang Tsung in Mortal Kombat. And then, of course, there's a character that's Raiden was totally ripped off from. There was a these thunder wizard type guys. A lot of the feel and look of this is totally Mortal Kombat. I would say if you take these two movies, Enter the Dragon and Big Trouble Little China, if you put them together, you would get Mortal Kombat. And then of course there's Mortal Kombat 2, which is a guilty pleasure of mine. I think it's corny as heck. I like it. I enjoy it. It's got the guy that plays Ajax from the Warriors plays Raiden in it, and it's got that one big dude. You see him in Van Damme or Stallone movies. He plays Shao Kahn. Robin Hsu plays Liu Kang again. He's good as Liu Kang, and Talisa Soto is back. Thankfully, I think Sonya and Johnny Cage are different. Keith Cook is in here playing Sub-Zero. I'm a big fan of his. And then what else we got? Okay, so then after Enter the Dragon, Bruce Lee died. I think before it was even released in theaters, around the same time. And he hadn't completed the Game of Death yet, filmed over in Hong Kong or China. Wherever it was never completed until 5 or 6 years later. In 78, it was Frankenstein together into a new movie called Game of Death. And it's sort of a hacked movie, but man, I really like this movie. I love Game of Death. Robert Klaus, that directed Enter the Dragon, directs this. A lot of scenes from the original you see in the tower where he fights Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Dan Inosanto. That's from the original vision, but a lot of this is just a new story put in here. I really like the story. I like all the goons in here. Bob Wall's back again. His girlfriend or his wife is Colleen Camp. This is a really cool movie, really Frankenstein together. A lot of it's unforgivable how they use like cardboard cutouts of Bruce Lee to make it look like it's him. There's a double of Bruce Lee, and then they use old footage from old movies of Bruce Lee to Frankenstein this thing together. But I think the double is good, and the stunt double and the look-alike for Bruce Lee are really good in this, and there's some good fights. He has a cool fight with Bob Wall, and Bob Wall has a cool fight with Sammo Hung, who was also in Enter the Dragon. Man, I really like this movie. I'm sorry. And then there's Game of Death 2. That's even more of a hack movie. It shows Bruce Lee here, but it's just more archive footage of Bruce Lee, Frankenstein into a new movie. Bruce Lee's character, Billy Low, dies halfway through, and then his brother takes revenge, so Bruce Lee isn't really even the star of this. I think the same guy that was the stunt double in the other one plays the main lead, and he's really good. There's some good fights in this. Bruce fights up the tower in Game of Death. This one, Bruce's brother fights down a tower, like an underground tower, level by level. He fights a different boss, and it sort of feels like a video game. He has a lot of obstacles. The last fight at the bottom is epic. This is a cool movie. I don't care if it's a hack movie. I like it. And all of those Bruce Lee movies came in a set. The Enter the Dragon wasn't in here, but all the other ones were. And then old Fist of Fear, Touch of Death, another hack movie. This isn't even really a real movie. It's just sort of like a variety show or just a bunch of little skits. There's some real actual kickboxing matches. There's some old footage of Bruce Lee's acting before he was in martial art movies. Like from old movies he acted in, there's footage of that. There's just little funny skits in here. Fred Williamson's in here. He has some pretty funny parts in here. I like this movie too. It's very holds a place in my heart. Okay, so now on to the Van Damme movies. He was probably the next best thing after Bruce Lee, and mostly because of this movie right here, Bloodsport. And I don't have a single copy of that. I have a double pack here. One side of the disc is Bloodsport. One is Showdown in Little Tokyo with Brandon Lee, who's badass in this, and Dolph Lundgren's a stud in here. And also, the guy that plays Shang Tsung is in here. I can never pronounce his name. He's the bad guy. Anyway, Bloodsport, though, with Van Damme. This is another one of my favorite movies, probably top five. Right there up with Enter the Dragon. Great fighting movie, great martial art montages, great training montages, great music, great plot. I love the story of a fighter going to a tournament and fighting a bunch of different unique fighters from different countries. Sort of what got me interested in playing Street Fighter. Actually, this movie is what got me into martial arts. Probably when I was like 12 or 13 or 14, I started judo, which is nothing like anything in this, but just from watching this movie, it wanted me to take martial arts, and I took judo for like 15 years after that. And this is one of the main reasons I got into judo. Bloodsport, awesome movie. Bolo Young is in there. He was in Enter the Dragon also. He's almost 50 in this movie. He looks really good. He's a bodybuilder, this guy, Bolo Young. Bolo Young's in this epic movie. And then some more Bolo Young movies. I have this Breathing Fire I got for a buck, but I haven't watched that yet, so I'm kind of curious to watch that. Here's one of my favorite series, martial art movie series. Of course, I think they were straight to video. I don't know if these came out at the show. The Tiger Claws series. Here's this beautiful Tiger Claws laser disc I have. It's got Bolo in there. Also, it has Jalal Murhi and Cynthia Rothrock, two of my other favorite straight-to-video martial art action stars. I like them probably more than most big movie stars. Cynthia Rothrock is so quick and fast and looks amazing. I like Jalal Murhi too. I like a lot of his movies. Tiger Claws is about a serial killer. I don't want to give the plot away, but they're trying to find a martial arts serial killer. That these two are cops. Jalal Murhi and Cynthia Rothrock are martial art cops trying to track down a martial arts serial killer who goes around killing other martial artists. So. Jalal Murhi has a lot of little training montages, little fight montages to learn this tiger claw art that the assassin uses. He's like a tiger. He shreds people with his bare hands like a tiger. And then old Tiger Claws 2 here on DVD, again with Cynthia Rothrock on there and Jalal Murhi, they're cops again, and this time Bolo Yang gets broken out of jail. And this one goes off the deep end, and it sort of turns into Mortal Kombat itself. There's a big tournament held, and it gets very mystic at the end, sort of like Mortal Kombat. So I like this one. It's corny as heck, but I love it. There's a lot of good scenes from Bolo Yang. Bolo Yang's a really cool, like, he doesn't talk that much, but his facial expressions are really good, sort of like Charles Bronson. Like, his facial expressions really say a lot in these movies. And then Tiger Claws 3. Again, Cynthia Rothrock is in there, but very briefly. She's not in this one too much. Jalal Murhi is the cop again, and this one gets really wacky. The first one had nothing science fiction too much. The second one had a little bit. This one's just like Superman 2 with ninjas. Like, there's these ninja warriors that get summoned magically, and there's a boy, a girl. There are two boys and a girl, just like the Kryptonians, and they have superpowers. They can throw Hadoukens and shoot lightning, and they get summoned by an evil wizard, and they just wreak havoc around the city, and Jalal Murhi is trying to stop them. Bolo Yang is not in this one. That guy Carter Wong from Big Trouble in Little China is in here, though. that guy. This movie is kooky as heck. I like it though, and the evil wizard that summons them is Lauren Avedon from King of the Kickboxers. He's the bad guy in this. He's a cool bad guy, like a sleazy smart aleck bad guy. That's why I like this movie. My other Jalal Marhi movie is, here's one nice beautiful laser disc here, Talons of the Eagle, with Jalal Marhi and Billy Blanks, who's another one of my favorite. I love all of Billy Blanks' movies. Before he was into the exercise videos, he was in these cool martial art movies. This is sort of like the 90s version of Enter the Dragon, similar plot. Jalal Marhi and Billy Blanks are cops or agents going undercover to bring this guy down that runs a tournament, and it's James Hong from Big Trouble in Little China. He's sort of like the Shang Tsung slash Mr. Han of this movie, and Jalal Marhi and Billy Blanks are the cops. I really like these two guys together. The bad guy, of course, one of the top goon is Matthias Hughes, that big blonde Fabio looking guy, who was like the bad guy in every single one of these movies back in the day. Like, he played like the same main goon in all of these movies. Him and that guy James Liu, they were always the goons in these movies, and they were always awesome. Oh, and then Bond girl Priscilla Barnes is in here, who was in License to Kill. She played Felix Leiter's wife in License to Kill. I don't know if she's a Bond girl or a Leiter girl, but she's in here. She's sort of like the undercover agent that's been that's been working for James Hong, sort of like the girl in Enter the Dragon. Oh man, cool movie. You're like, okay, if you say so, Steve. And then, Operation Golden Phoenix with Jalal Marhi. This is a cool action movie, low budget. James Hong is the bad guy once again, and he brings it. All these low budget, straight to video movies, James Hong still brings his A game. Jalal Marhi's in here doing jump kicks and whatnot, just like on the cover. It's a lot of it's set in Lebanon, and there's a lot of ancient, like, Lebanese ruins, so it's a lot of pretty backdrops for a lot of these fight scenes. Another guy in here is Lauren Avedon again, who's the bad guy, and he fights Jalal Marhi. And I think that other gal, Karen Shepherd, who's been in a few of these other martial arts movies, she's in here doing all kinds of cool martial arts. Cool movie. And then another Jalal Marhi, one I have Expect to Die. This is, of course, Jalal Marhi's a cop again, and he's trying to find this killer, and it's David Bradley from the American Ninja, the American Ninja and American Samurai movies. He's like this bad guy that puts people inside of these video games, and he kills them in the game, and when they die in the game, they die in real life. And David Bradley is the bad guy, and he fights with Jalal Marhi, and they go inside the video game and all that. It's really corny, but I like it. And then one of the newer Jalal Marhis I have, this one also has David Carradine and Olivier Gruner. Guaranteed on Arrival, cool action movie, really corny, but I like this one. It has a cool premise. Also, that other martial art guy, his name is Darren Shalavi, but he passed away not long ago. He wasn't that old, unfortunately. He has a little part in here, and he fights Jalal Marhi. He's one of the goons. So I like this movie. I'm glad I found it at Rasputin's for 50 cents. And then some other good Bloodsport ripoffs here. I have this nice little Kung Fu collection. I've watched all of these. These are all cool, like Chinese movies. Fist of Fury is in here. Crippled Masters. The Street Fighter. Some of the Sonny Chiba movies are in here. The one I wanted to highlight is Blood Fist. It's a Bloodsport ripoff. It's a Hong Kong made movie. It's very similar to Bloodsport. Even Bolo Young is in it, and he plays a character almost exactly like Chong Li in Bloodsport. You gotta watch that movie. It's on Tubi, I think. I'm for sure you can get a free version on YouTube, but it's probably cleaner looking on Tubi. Blood Fight, you gotta watch that. It's a total ripoff of Bloodsport. Bolo Young's character is like Chong Lo or something instead of Chong Li. It's very similar, and the fans are chanting King Lo, or whatever it is. Very similar to Chong Li in Bloodsport. But I wish I had a copy of that movie on its own. Blood Fight, very cool. Here's one of the best Bloodsport ripoffs with David Bradley here again, American Samurai. This is like Bloodsport with weapons. So if Bloodsport is Tekken, American Samurai is Soul Calibur. This is like a tournament, like an underground tournament this guy goes to. And everyone has weapons. There's all kinds of different fighters. Like there's samurais, there's an Australian guy with a knife. And there's like a Conan the Barbarian looking guy. They're all different types of weapon fighters in this tournament. So it gets kind of gory. And Mark Dacascos is the bad guy, and he's an awesome bad guy in this. He's probably like steals the show in this movie. Very cool movie. I like David Bradley in American Samurai. Probably David Bradley's best movie as far as I know. And then we'll get into some Don the Dragon Wilsons. Here's a good Bloodsport ripoff. Blood Fist. All these blood this, blood that. Blood Fist with Don the Dragon Wilson. This is a cool Bloodsport ripoff. This is probably one of the top Bloodsport ripoffs. He's looking for the murderer of his friend or his brother. His brother dies in this tournament like the Kumite type thing, and I think it's either in Thailand or I can't remember where it is, but he goes to look for the killer of his brother. And he meets up a new trainer, and he gets trained to fight in this tournament. And he meets a girl, and he meets a buddy. And it's a lot like Bloodsport in many ways, and there's a little twist at the end, too. And he fights Billy Blanks as the boss in here, or the last guy he fights in the tournament. So Billy Blanks versus Don the Dragon Wilson, which is cool. Billy Blanks and Don the Dragon Wilson are probably two of my favorites. martial art movie guys. So that's a cool movie. And then I wanted to throw this one in here, Dragonfire, another Roger Corman Presents, just like most of the Don the Dragon ones. This is not Don the Dragon Wilson, it's some guy named Dominic LaBanca. But this movie is the exact same plot as Blood Fist. He goes to, his brother goes missing, he's a fighter, he's presumed dead or missing, and his brother goes to look for the killer, he joins a tournament, he gets a new manager, he meets a girl that's a stripper, just like Blood Fist, same exact plot, I think it's the same writer, this is like the exact same movie as Blood Fist, only this one is in outer space, yeah, it's like a sci-fi, he goes to outer space, that's where his brother was killed, so. Not too much about this scream sci-fi. There's like some of the costumes or whatever in the scenery and the sets look sci-fi-ish, like Blade Runner-esque. But not much about it is sci-fi. Billy Blanks' brother, I think it's Michael Blanks, is the main baddie in here, or the last fighter. But this is a pretty cool martial arts a tournament underground fighting type movie. I recommend it. Blood Fist is probably better, but they're both, you can't go wrong with either one, but if you've seen one, you've seen them both. There was also another one with Jerry Trimble that had the exact same plot. I wish I had that one, but I don't. Blood Fist 2, this is a cool, I like this one too. This one, Don the Dragon Wilson gives up on fighting because he killed someone, he doesn't want to fight anymore, but then his buddy suckers him into going somewhere, and then he ends up getting captured with a bunch of other top martial artists to fight for rich people in death matches. That's the premise. Like a bunch of martial artists are captured to fight death matches on an island. And the last guy in here, he fights as Maurice Smith, the UFC, the former UFC heavyweight champion, who actually, he fought Don the Dragon Wilson in a real kickboxing match. They must have been buddies. And then on with the Blood Fist movies. Here's a Don the Dragon Wilson pack I have, which is awesome. Blood Fist 3, Forced to Fight. After Blood Fist 2, it's not even the same character. It's just Don the Dragon Wilson's in it, so we'll slap Blood Fist on it. These don't have anything to do with each other, these two Blood Fists. They don't have anything to do with any of the previous ones, nor any of the later ones. They're all different, totally different movies with different... Don the Dragon Wilson plays something different in every single movie. So it's just Blood Fist by name. Blood Fist 3, Forced to Fight. That's a cool prison movie in the same vein as... Death Warrants with Van Damme. It's a pretty cool movie, actually. It's got Shaft in there, the guy that plays Shaft. I think it's a pretty quality Roger Corman movie. And then Blood Fist 4, Die Trying, is a cool action suspense movie. And it's got, he has a fight with Gary Daniels in there. And I think even Principal Strickland from Back to the Future is like an FBI agent in that one. And then Black Belt is another one with Don the Dragon Wilson. He fights Matthias Hughes again, of course. Matthias Hughes fights everyone. He's always the bad guy in a lot of these movies. Black Belt sort of like... Kevin Costner's the bodyguard, but it's with Don the Dragon Wilson. He's trying to protect this singer, this diva, and there's a serial killer after her, and he's been killing other women. Matthias Hughes, and one of the bad guys in here, I can't think of the actor's name, but he played Ben Horn in Twin Peaks. He's a bad guy in here, a snivelly bad guy. I think Don the Dragon Wilson beats his face in towards the end. And then I have this nice little Cyber Tracker pack with Don the Dragon Wilson. This has Cyber Tracker 1 and 2, which are like sort of like Terminator type ripoffs, like sci-fi action movies. Richard Norton's in here, he fights with him. And then it has Ring of Fire 1 and Ring of Fire 3. Those are two other Don the Dragon Wilson series, Cyber Tracker and Ring of Fire. Ring of Fire is a little romantic action movie. Ring of Fire 3 is sort of like he gets hunted down in the wilderness, and the opening scene of this movie is just a bunch of action that has nothing to do with the rest of the movie. It's very weird, but I like it. Check out the Ring of Fires. I wish they had Ring of Fire 2. That one's the coolest one. And then I have another single copy of Cyber Tracker here. This must be a Roger Corman Presents. I'm not sure. Imperial Entertainment. Yeah. It's either that or PM or Roger Corman. And here's a Don the Dragon Wilson movie that's really good, directed by Art Camacho, one of the top stunt guys, top stunt coordinators. He even has little bit parts in a lot of these movies, Art Camacho. Here's Redemption with Don Wilson, Cynthia Rothrock again, and Chris Penn. A lot of other little parts in here, like Sam Jones from Flash Gordon, and... that guy, I think, what's his name, Stephen Vincent Lee from some of the other martial art movies, and Richard Norton's in here, kind of the antagonizing SWAT team buddy. They're a SWAT team. Cynthia Rothrock isn't in it that long, unfortunately. This is a cool action drama thriller with Don the Dragon Wilson in it. Here's another Don the Dragon Wilson, a very recent one. He's really old in here. And look who else is in there, Cynthia Rothrock. And she's looking hot as ever. Like she's a nice, hot-looking senior citizen. You can't tell us she's a senior citizen. So was Don the Dragon Wilson. Cool little action movie. This is a guy here. I think this is the last time we ever see Joe Louis the fighter, not or Joe Louis the karate fighter, not Joe Louis the boxer. Joe Louis the karate fighter, the kickboxer. I think this is the last time he was ever in a movie. I think he died shortly after this. He had a small part. This guy here, Matt Mullins, is kind of like a new up and coming guy. I don't think martial art movies are that big anymore. It's just like Scott Atkins and Michael Jai White and a few others. Hopefully they get popular again with that Mortal Kombat movie. And we get more straight to DVD movies. Anyway, Death Fighter is a cool action movie, very recent. Okay, here we go. Back to Jean-Claude Van Damme, Kickboxer, one of his other iconic movies here. Really cool movie. Tong Po is a great villain, just like Chong Li from Bloodsport. I don't have Kickboxer 2, but I do have Kickboxer 3, The Arts of War, which really goes off the beaten path. And Kickboxer 4, The Aggressor. That Kickboxer 4 is a guilty pleasure for me. Really corny. Tong Po is back, but he doesn't, it's not played by the same guy, and he has terrible makeup. Fun movie. He's trying to, this guy Sasha Mitchell replaces Van Damme, and he's supposed to be Van Damme's brother, and he's going to join a martial arts tournament to save his wife, who's been captured by Tong Po. So corny, but I love it. A great movie. Cyborg with Jean-Claude Van Damme. This one always scared me as a kid. It has some good action. He's always on the run. There's these scary post-apocalyptic guys chasing him. I love this director, Albert Pyun, is one of my favorite directors. I like the look and feel and the music and everything in this movie. And I didn't realize that there was a canceled He-Man movie and a canceled Spider-Man movie. The leftover props and set pieces, they Frankenstein together for stuff for this movie, so I thought that was kind of cool. And then here, this doesn't have Van Damme, but here's Cyborg 2. It's not really a martial art movie. It's got Jack Palance in there, and Casey Jones from Ninja Turtles, and Angelina Jolie when she was very young. I think Casey Jones gets it on with Angelina Jolie in here. Go Casey! Before I forget, Kickboxer 4 and Cyborg, directed by Albert Pyun. Who also directed this lovely movie here, Heatseeker, with Keith Cook. From King of the Kickboxers and Gary Daniels. This is a cool Albert Pyun movie. I love his style. This is sort of like Street Fighter or Mortal Kombat with cyborgs. It's like in the future, all of the biotech people are building parts, and different companies are competing in fighting tournaments to show which parts are superior. So cyborgs fight each other in blood sport type matches. And Keith Cook here is the last full human. Everyone else has cybernetic parts, and he's the last human, but he still kicks all their heinies. So this is a cool movie. I like this movie. It's in the same vein as Kickboxer or Bloodsport, but with cyborgs, so it's kind of sci-fi. It has a little part, what's his name? Tim Thomerson is in there briefly, from a lot of other Albert Pyun movies, and he was in the Trancers series. So cool movie there. Okay, I don't have Lionheart with Van Damme, but I have this Michael Jai White movie, Blood and Bone, which is like the same exact plot. Really cool movie. Like a guy, I think he gets out of prison in this. I think Van Damme escaped from the Legionnaires in Lionheart, and he went to go support his brother's family. His brother died, and he wants to go support his sister-in-law and their baby. So he has to join, he has to do fighting, like street fighting, to make the money. And it's the same plot in this. It's Michael Jai White. He has some cool fights in here. He fights Bob Sapp in here, the fighter, and Kimbo Slice. Kind of cool. There's even a little cameo from Bob Wall in here from Enter the Dragon. I like this movie a lot for a newer movie. Okay, Double Impact. This is one of Van Damme's best movies. This is such a fun movie to watch. Not only a great martial art movie, but a great action movie. Van Damme brings it in here. He plays two parts. He plays twin brothers. And both of them are very different, but he pulls off both of them really well. Bolo Young is in here. He's one of the main baddies. This is a really cool movie. I'm sure you've heard of it. Before I forget, Van Damme in Hard Target, cool Manhunt movie with Van Damme. Yeah, I'll just leave it at that. Street Fighter, the movie, I was really hyped for this, being a fan of Street Fighter and a fan of Van Damme movies. I was super hyped for this. I saw this at the show the weekend it came out with my buddy. And it didn't really deliver, but I enjoy it. It's like another guilty pleasure for me. I always can put this movie on and enjoy it. It's probably the worst Van Damme movie. Van Damme doesn't have any lines, and he barely has any fights. He only has like one little fight at the end. The guy that steals the show pretty much is Raul Julia right here, who plays M. Bison. I wish we'd get more adaptations of M. Bison that are like this. Yeah, but no one else in the game really. I guess they're sort of decent, but it's not really that good of an adaptation of the game. I remember when I was reading Electronic Gaming Monthly when I was a kid, they had a write-up, an interview with the director of this, Steven D'Souza. And they had an interview with him, and he was saying, "Oh, how many of these movies have you seen before where there's a fighter entering a tournament to prove himself? Well, that's been done a million times before. We're gonna make this more like Star Wars." And right when I read that, I'm like, "Oh man, this is gonna be garbage." And it was, but it's cool garbage. Like I said, I can put this on any time and enjoy it. So I really wouldn't want it any other way. So I'll kind of transition into video game martial art movies from there. Here's DOA, Dead or Alive, which I have not really seen yet. I've seen bits and parts of it, and I was kind of interested in it, but now I'm really interested in it because Corey Yun is the director. He did a lot of old Hong Kong action movies. He did some scenes from King of the Kickboxers, which was one of my favorites, and No Retreat, No Surrender. He did that movie with Van Damme. So man, this is, I just gotta watch it just for that. And not only that, but Sho Kasugi's son, Kane Kasugi, is in here, and he plays Ryu Hayabusa. So this is the only time as far as I know, it's the only live action version of Ryu Hayabusa from Ninja Gaiden in a movie, and it's played by Kane Kasugi, so I guess that's cool. And then speaking of Kane Kasugi, here's Tekken Kazuya's Revenge. And this has a Kane Kasugi in it, and this really goes off the beaten path from Tekken. As far as I know, this has nothing to do with the plot from Tekken, which kind of makes it cool. It's kind of its own unique standalone martial art movie, and I kind of like it. It's not bad. I don't really care much for the first Tekken movie. This one is really different. It's really low budget, but I think it's good for what it is. And Gary Daniels is in here very briefly, and he plays Brian Fury, the guy from Tekken, who's kind of like a cyborg. So that's fitting that he would play a cyborg type of guy, just like he did in Heatseeker. He plays like a cybernetic fighter in there. So Gary Daniels to play Brian Fury is perfect. And then what do we got? Oh, my buddy Segalacious from the Virtua Brothers, who's I don't think there's a bigger Virtua Fighter fan than him, and he's not only a fan, like, he is a pro at it. He can tear up any Virtua Fighter game, hardest difficulty with any character, always can beat Dural at the end. He was, I think he's embarrassed to admit it, but he likes these Virtua Fighter cartoon series, the Virtua Fighter anime, and I like it too. I'm not embarrassed to say it. I'm not really into anime, but I really enjoyed this series, Virtua Fighter. Only the first season and a half is in English. I can't find the second season. It's all in Japanese, and even no English subtitles or anything. The Virtua Fighter. I like this series because it's kind of more heavy on the martial arts and fighting, other than like sci-fi and mystical stuff. There is some of that in here, like everything, but it's not like Tekken where it just gets totally off the beaten path. It's mostly just about like martial artists and their little stories. But I really like this series. I know it takes a lot of liberties. A lot of the characters are not similar to the game, but I enjoy this. The other one I like is Fatal Fury, the Fatal Fury trilogy, but I cannot find those on DVD. But that's another cool little anime trilogy, the Fatal Fury series. And then what else do we have here? That's it for the video game stuff. Back to Van Damme. Here's Sudden Death, a good little Die Hard movie at a hockey match. Here's one of my other favorite Van Damme movies, The Quest. This is just sort of like a remake of Bloodsport set in the 20s. Van Damme stars again. Great movie. Kind of very pretty visuals. I think Van Damme even directed this. And it's not that bad. I think it's a decent movie. And Roger Moore is in here. He's like my favorite actor of all time. This, the third James Bond. He plays like a pirate in this. What's his name from? James Remar. Yeah, James Remar that played Raiden and Ajax in the Warriors. He plays a cool character in here called Maxi Divine. That's like one of those old school like boxers from the 20s. This is all, everyone's going to this tournament. There's invitations to the top martial artists to go to this tournament. It's in the middle of China or somewhere in Indonesia. I can't remember where it is, but this is a cool, nice movie. I would have liked more from the fighting. All the fights are really short and they're all in slow motion. I wish we would have gotten more out of that, but overall I like this movie. Recommend it. Cool. Here's a sealed copy of Legionnaire, one of the last decent Van Damme movies. And then, sorry to end it on this one, I don't have anything to say about it, The Order with Van Damme. I kind of want to watch this because Sheldon Lettish directed it, and he directed a lot of previous Van Damme movies. And I think he even fights that guy, Oleg Brian Thompson's in here again, Shao Kahn. He even fights the Mongolian fighter. I think his name was Khan from The Quest. I think the same bad guy is in here. And then Charlton Heston is in here, The Order. So I gotta watch this one. Anyway, that's my martial arts movie collection as of May 2021. Let me know if you see anything there you like or you want to tell me about that I haven't seen. Or let me know what your favorite martial art movies are. I'm sure there's a lot of Jackie Chan, Jet Li, Seagal movies that I missed too. You sort of see my taste in martial art movies are like the corny 90s ones. But let me know what your favorite martial art movie is or who your favorite martial art movie star is. After Van Damme and Bruce Lee, like I like a lot of them, like Don the Dragon Wilson, Billy Blanks, Cynthia Rothrock, Jalal Mirheib, Gary Daniels. There's a lot of cool ones. Like I don't even have the best of the best movies. A lot more movies I want to get, but most of them you can watch on YouTube, thankfully, or check out Tubi, the free streaming service. Anyway, thanks for sticking around so long. It's been fun. Talk to you later. Bye. Thank you.
magical flute sail on into the sky. Is this a glad song? Makes my heart go crazy, mad song. Or will the sound turn to silence and singing?